At the polling station, we've made mechanism to ensure that there is transparency. When you come to the polling station, there are expectation you're asked of your ID, and someone checks the ID and your face and gives it to the first clerk, and the first clerk asks you to put your finger on the BVR kit. So that procedure, we have ensured that the voter education process is ongoing. It is ongoing in the grassroots, in our constituency level. Our returning officers are having stakeholders engagement, and they are training people on how to vote, the voting process, and the tallying, and the result management. So with that voter education process, we assure that we're going to get a high level of preparedness from the people. Our people will know how to vote. We'll have less of the spoiled ballot papers, and the turnout, we expect the turnout to be high. Something else that we've done, we have partnered with security agency to ensure that we have security for our staff, security for the materials, security for the voters. And still the National Police is manning the whole country. And basically to ensure that we have a peaceful process. And you'll come to the polling station, you will vote, and you'll go back home. Another thing that we've ensured a good experience with our brothers and sisters who are living with disability, we've ensured that this time round, if they come to the polling station, they will be given priority. Just like the pregnant women will be given priority and the women with small babies. Something funny that happened in 2017, that there is this scenario because people are given priority with babies and we have a baby exchange hands. Yeah.